Okay, so in this video we'll talk about unit conversion. So we talked about in the last video that the SI units are kind of like our oasis where things are self-bookkeeping. We want to make sure our lengths are in meters, our times are in seconds, etc. And if you have something that's in something else, then we need to quickly rectify that so that it's not anarchy. But then the question is, how do you actually practically go about doing that? If something's in not in what you want, it's a length, but it's not in meters, how do you go about fixing that? So what I want to do is talk about this. Now, unit conversion is something that we all do. We all do just kind of in our heads. We look up the conversion factor, we multiply or divide, and then we have our answer. About the only thing you can do is to go wrong is to accidentally multiply instead of divide. But other than that, you'd think it's a kind of a simple process. But with more complex conversions, it really pays to have a system in place where you won't mess up. So I want to talk about what that system is. It's based off two mathematical principles. The first of which is that if you have any number, so I'll just have smiley face standing for that. If you multiply it by 1, well, it's still smiley face, okay? Right? So multiplying by 1 does not accomplish anything. You get back the same thing that you put in. The second is that any number, 15,872, if you divide it by 15,872 as well, the same thing, you'll get 1. So any number divided by itself is just 1, okay? I'm not even going to get into 0 divided by 0. That's a whole different thing, but let's assuming that it's not 0. Any number divided by itself just gives you 1. So why am I telling you this? That'll become clear hopefully in a second, but at least hopefully you don't dispute that these two mathematical axioms are the case. So if I were to say smiley face times 15,872 over 15,872, you would get back smiley face. So you get back the same thing. So what does this, any of this have to do with unit conversion? Well, smiley face can be a stand-in for any physical quantity. So any physical quantity. And if we wish to do a unit conversion on that, we don't want to change how much it is, right? So if you took, say, 5 meters and you multiplied it by 2, that's 10 meters, and 10 meters is no longer the same as 5 meters. What we want to do is take the thing that we have and convert it to being expressed differently, but still the same amount. So what we want to come out the other end is actually the same amount of physical quantity, okay? So we don't want it to be bigger or smaller, we want the same thing out. So what we have to multiply here is some funny way of saying 1. So this whole thing is really a unity. And so in order for it to be a funny way of saying 1, we have to have the same amount of stuff in the top and on the bottom. So the only thing we can really multiply is a ratio with the same amount in the numerator and the denominator. Otherwise, we're multiplying by something else besides 1. So that's what we're doing with unit conversion. We're taking a quantity, which we want to convert. We are going to end up with the same physical quantity, but if we're clever, we can get the same physical quantity in different units. So we're expressing that amount of stuff differently. And so that is when we're clever with the ratio. Okay, so we're clever with how we express this ratio. Let me give you an example, okay? So let's say I have a quantity like 6.6 feet, okay? Now if you see that in a problem, immediate red flag. You don't want to be in feet if you want your lengths to be in meters, okay? So we want to get that into so and so many meters, yet to be determined how many. So we want to multiply by a smart way of saying 1. So we set up our ratio and want the same amount of stuff up top and down below. Now we have to now look up the conversion factor, and we can find that 1 meter is the same as 3.3 feet. I gave it to you last lecture, so you should already have that in your lecture notes. common question is, do you need to memorize that for the exams? No, you don't. Okay, so if I want you to do some kind of conversion where you need to convert feet to meters, for instance, I will need to tell you how many feet are in a meter. You'll notice that on the equation sheet, prefixes are there, so I shouldn't have to tell you in the problem what the prefix is. You can look that up on the equation sheet, but anything that's not on the equation sheet, you shouldn't need to memorize as far as the various units. So I put the 1 meter and 3.3 feet. Those are equivalent. Now, how did I decide to put one in the top and the one in the bottom? Well, I wanted the feet to cancel. So what if I had put 3.3 feet up top and 1 meter down below? Would that have been wrong? It wouldn't have been wrong. 3.3 feet is a meter, but it wouldn't have gotten us anywhere. So we don't want to do that. We also don't want to make the mistake. Sometimes students do this where they say, you might accidentally do 3.3 meters or let's say we might say it's feet and meters, and that of course would cancel appropriately, the feet and the feet, but you'd sometimes students accidentally put like 1 foot and 3.3 meters, and that's actually not correct because 3.3 meters is not the same thing as 1 foot. Okay, so that's definitely wrong. Okay, yes, the units would cancel, but it's not one. That's not a ratio where it's the same amount of stuff. Okay, so we go ahead. We see that the feet cancel, meters are there, and then 6.6 divided by 3.3, that's just 2. So 6.6 feet is the same length as 2 meters. Now, you might be thinking right now, like, wow, that's, why would you want to go to all this hassle? Obviously, you look at the conversion factor, it's 3.3. You think for a second and realize you should divide instead of multiply, and then you have your answer. So this is just the first of several examples, and I'm going to do several examples for you that get progressively harder, and I'd be willing to bet that for at least some of these, if I asked you to kind of do them in an informal way, you might actually come up with the wrong answer. So let me do a couple more for practice. You can watch me do them, and you'll have similar ones on your homework, and you can kind of see that the system pays off. Let's start the next one with a speed, 60 miles per hour. So that's how it's commonly written. Several problems with that. Normally, for miles, we use MI, okay? So M is reserved for meters, not miles. So then we don't need a P for per. We have a division symbol for that. And then hours, you can put H, or I like to put HR. So there's your speed kind of written more appropriately. And if you see that speed in a problem, your first instinct should be that is not an SI. So we need to get that converted before we launch with the problem. So we want to get that converted. We don't want our lengths to be in miles. We want them to be in meters. And we don't want our times in hours. We want them in seconds. So it's so and so many meters per second. Okay. Let me go like this. Meters per second, okay? So, where do we start? Well, this is simple enough that you can kind of think of it, these not as two units divided by each other, but just like one composite unit. So you're kind of thinking of these as just clumped together. You can look up and find out how many meter per seconds are in a mile per hour. So that is a conversion that you could probably still find. It's not complicated enough yet that you would have to worry about it. But I'm going to show you the stacking technique where you can convert the units in different pieces. So let's start by trying to get the length part taken care of. So I want to get rid of miles, replace it with meters, put the miles down below because I want it to cancel, meters up top to replace it. And then I look up, making sure to look up and put them in the right place. 1 mile is 1609 meters. Again, don't have to have that memorized. If I wanted you, you needed to know that on an exam, I would give it to you. So we have the miles cancel. We have meters left. up top. So our units right now, if we I stopped here, would be meters per hour. So I'm not done yet. So what do I do? Well, the beauty of this technique is that smiley face times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is still smiley face. So I can apply as many of these conversion factors as I want, and I still am not going to change the outcome. Whatever I'm going to get here, or whatever I have here in terms of speed, that is going to be the same speed over here, just expressed differently. These are all just funny ways of saying 1. And it turns out, I'm kind of filling in the blanks here, or kind of anticipating, I'm going to need to do the time in a two-step conversion. So while you might say, oh, I know how many seconds are in an hour, why don't we just go in one step? Let's kind of be systematic here. Let's go from hours to minutes first. Okay, so this is something that you should know, of course. This, you don't need to... you should know, it's not on the equation sheet, but you should know that 1 hour is 60 minutes. Okay, so the hours cancel. Now I have meters per minute. Meters per minute. And then one more step, since the minutes are down below, I put the minutes up top, and I want to go into seconds. And so the minutes are going to cancel. I'm going to wind up with seconds down below. And of course, 1 minute is 60 seconds. Okay. So what do I have? Now I have meters per second, all right? So I've accumulated a bunch of numbers along with that. I have 60 times 1609 divided by 60 times 60. You can crunch that in your calculator. You might cancel these out just to save yourself some trouble. And 1609 divided by 60, that is about 26.8. Let's just call it 27, okay? So a speed of 60 miles an hour is the same as a speed of about 27 meters per second. Now I picked this conversion not only because I could show you a multi-step conversion, but I also wanted to try to develop your intuition, okay? Now I think most people's intuition about speeds comes from riding around in cars, so you have a sense of how fast 10 miles an hour versus 50 miles an hour is, but you might not have a lot of intuition about speeds in meters per second, okay? So I want to point out that roughly it's about half, okay? So if you take the speed in meters per second and you multiply by 2, you get approximately the speed in miles per hour. That's just a rule of thumb, okay? So, not exactly. Obviously, this is not 30. So, if you take the speed in meters per second, multiply by 2, it should roughly be the speed in miles per hour. So, this, like many things, I want you to try to develop some intuition, okay? So, every problem you do in physics is the answer to something in the real world, probably something that you've seen. So, for instance, if you solve a problem and you get that a dog is running at 70 meters per second, okay, you should probably rethink that answer because that's about 140 miles per hour. So, that seems a little fast for a dog, okay, to be running. So, whenever you get your answers at the end of a problem, check them against your real-world intuition. Make sure that it sort of makes sense, okay? So there's my second example. Let me just knock out a couple more. Kind of show you some pitfalls. Let's take, let's say the speed of light, 3 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. Now that's already an SI, so that'd be fine as is, but let's say for some reason, somebody asks you to convert this into, how many meters does light travel in a nanosecond, okay? So light travels very fast, and so maybe it travels not quite so far if you give it a much, much smaller fraction of a second to travel. So let's convert that. So, I'm interested in replacing the seconds, so the seconds down below, and I want to get it into nanoseconds. Okay, so that's going to cancel with that. Now, then of course, I need to set this up for this ratio properly. Now watch how I do this. 1 nanosecond is 1 × 10⁻⁹ seconds. Okay. So notice that everything matches up with the numerator and denominator. This is a funny way of saying 1. So if you look here, 1 matches up with 1. Seconds matches up with seconds. And nano is a stand-in for 10⁻⁹. Okay. So a common mistake that students do when they're doing these conversions, they might say this, 1 second per 1 × 10⁻⁹ nanoseconds, okay? That's actually double counting. You're putting both the nano and the number in the same place, okay? In fact, that would be equivalent to 1 second over 1 × 10⁻⁹ seconds, okay? Clearly not a ratio of 1, okay? So make sure you, when you're converting, including prefixes, that you just kind of think through 1, 1, seconds, seconds, 10⁻⁹, stand in for nano, okay? So what do I have? I have now meters, which is what I want, nanoseconds on the bottom. I have 3 × 10⁸ times 1 × 10⁻⁹. So 10⁸ times 10⁻⁹, that's just 3⁻⁰, so that's 0.3. So make sure you understand these are the kind of things that I'm hoping you'll bring in from your math prereq, okay? So light, as fast as it is, in fact, it's the fastest speed possible in the universe, light in a nanosecond only has a chance to travel 0.3 meters, which is about the width of this page, okay? So in 1 nanosecond, light has a chance to travel from one side of this page basically to the other, okay? So that's a example. I guess that was the third example, and it kind of works in some prefixes. Let's do another one. Another tricky one is area. So let's say you have an area of about 100 square feet, maybe the size of a small, a relatively small room, okay? So that's an area. I want to get it into square meters, obviously, if I want to work in SI. So common, let's start here. I want to get from feet, so I put in the denominator to cancel with this, and I want to end up in meters. Again, 1 meter is 3.3 feet. And a common mistake would just be to stop there, but you notice that it's not going to work out. This feet is only going to cancel with one of these. So what's going to be left with is feet times meters, and that's not right. So I'm going to have to apply this conversion twice, okay? So I'm going to have to apply the same exact factor again to get rid of both of these feet. Now, just so to save myself some room, instead of writing this factor out again, let me just square it. Same thing, right? So what do I have? 100 square feet times, and now this square distributes, so it's 1 squared meter squared over 3.3 squared feet squared. So the feet squared now do cancel, but what do I have in meters squared? Well, I have to take 100, divide it not by 3.3, but 3.3 squared, okay? And that number is 9.18 square meters, okay? So again, if you use this system, you will find that you'll catch these kind of mistakes if you're just kind of making sure to account for everything canceling like it should, okay? So that's a bit about unit conversion. You'll have that on your homework 1, and we'll move on to the next video.